Modernizing with cloud IT is more than hosting infrastructure in Azure with virtual machines. There's so many options available for cloud computing that you really can propel your business faster and further if you just know about and embrace some of the new modern options that allow you to get more compute done in faster periods of time and allow your business to get things done faster without you having to manage so much of the infrastructure. Maybe we should talk about that a little bit. Oh, wait a second. That's a pizza guy. One sec. Hey, Dana App here. Welcome to the show that helps Azure administrators to know ops and, well, master the Microsoft cloud. You know, just before I get into this pizza here, when I think of cloud computing, I think pizza might be a great analogy to try to help understand the different options that are available. Think about it for a second. When you make a pizza at home, you're in complete control of it, right? You make the dough and you put on the sauce and you select the right cheeses and the right toppings. And you're responsible for cooking it. And when you're done, you gotta cut it and serve it up. And hey, it's great. And it's built exactly the way you want it. And I think that's a great way of explaining infrastructure we have to manage on premises, right? And then we start thinking about options that are in the cloud. I think of a, you know, take and bake pizza where you don't have to worry about the crust or the ingredients. That's all taken care of for you. And then you just have to go to the freezer and pick it out and bring it home and then cook it up. You're still responsible for the electricity in the oven and making sure that's all there and cutting it up and serving it up. Of course, we could just easily pick up the phone and in which case you didn't have to think about any of that stuff, right? You make the order, but they take care of all the ingredients. They take care of cooking it. They take care of all electricity. They deliver it to you and you just got to enjoy it. And then of course, if I wanted to, I could go to a really good pizza place myself and just go in, dine in, eat there and take care of it. I think of making pizza at home is like your on-premises infrastructure. And those take and bake pizzas from the frozen food aisle, that's like your infrastructure as a service. And delivery, that is platform as a service. It's got some things you're still responsible for, but ultimately most taken care of. And then, of course, the piece de resistance, it's having that SaaS, having that pizza place you can go into, and it's all taken care of for you. And what's interesting is we can kind of correlate that to lots of different types of solutions available in Azure. Let's use SQL as a good example. You can easily go rack, stack, and cable infrastructure and have that run in on premises for you. You're responsible for installing Windows and you're responsible for setting up SQL Server and getting the licenses and taking care of all that. And that's how we've always done it. Of course, these days, you can go into the Azure Marketplace and you can buy the virtual machine compute you want and it can be pre-installed with Windows Server and with the SQL Server you want. Microsoft even goes so far as to make it available. So if you wanted a clustered SQL infrastructure, you can buy that, which will give you a full set of VMs properly configured for their default configuration. But what if you don't want to manage that? You know, it's possible when you have infrastructure that you have to take care of, that may not be your strong suit, that may not be your expertise. So why worry about that? There's options in the platform as a service where you can use something like Azure SQL Database, where you don't have to worry about the infrastructure at all. You don't have to worry about its configuration. You just host your data in the cloud using SQL Database. Now, maybe you have an application that isn't capable of using Azure SQL Database yet, and that exists. Well, then you have things like SQL Database Managed Instances, which is literally Microsoft taking advantage of their expertise and they're administering SQL Server for you in the cloud. Or you can go all the way up to modernizing on new data stores that you haven't thought about before, like Azure SQL Data Warehouse, or even moving to a NoSQL solution like Cosmos DB. Like there's so many different options that allows you to have the right flexibility and exchange cost for savings in time and effort from an administrator point of view. And I think that's one of those things that's missing today, is that we don't always look at those options available to us. We're so used to maintaining and managing that infrastructure that sometimes we have our blinders on and we're not looking at the new modern way that compute may be available to us. Now, I'm not a SQL guy. I'm not a guru when it comes to that kind of stuff, but what I find interesting is that I can leverage Microsoft's expertise and take advantage of some of those services, especially for the platform as a service, so that the common stuff, they take care of it. So then our engineers focusing on the data layer can leverage the cloud technology the way it's meant to be. But it's more than just data, because we're modernizing applications these days. So it's not always just your typical client server application. You now can take advantage of event-driven modern applications that are built out in many ways, even in serverless technology. You know, it's not just about running compute through an Azure virtual machine. You can take advantage of using modern web apps and containerizations, things like Azure Container Instances, giving you just-in-time compute when you need it to only do execution. So as an example for me at work, we have a bunch of reports that need to get generated every single week. And instead of having to worry about scaling that up all the time, we just use ACI. We use Azure Container Instances. We've built out containers specifically to do the jobs we needed to do. And then we use a scheduler through an Azure function that will load up that container, execute, do the work, store that securely in Azure Blob storage, and then give us the ability to alert us that the reports are ready. And all of that becomes a more modern way of taking advantage of compute in a way that makes more sense for us. As we've been growing, we've been able to scale that out so that we can get that same amount of compute done in a shorter period of time. And that's because we take advantage of things like Azure Functions and events and the event hub to be able to drive that stuff together. And these are all just different parts of where compute works out. So anyways, when you're thinking about compute, you have infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, software as a service. Find the one that makes the most sense. And the most sense in some cases may be if you're not an expert in that area and Microsoft's able to provide and deliver those services for you, what's the total cost of ownership for you? What options are available? Check them out, because you might find, in many ways, it's a lot easier than you think. And you've got to sit here with the pizza, which is smelling so good right now. Just remember, you can always make it at home. That is your on-premises infrastructure. And in the hybrid, you can continue to do that. While at the same time, you can modernize and lift and shift and move some of the stuff into the cloud and take advantage of that infrastructure as a service, that take and bake, so to speak, to make sure that some of that stuff that you don't need to worry about, we don't need to rack, stack, and cable everything anymore. And we can move from a more CapEx model to an OpEx model so we can pay as we grow, which is, I think, a better term than pay as you go, because at the end of the day, we pay what we need. And that starts to be very useful for us when we're trying to get more work done in less time. I can get infrastructure up a lot faster in the cloud than when I have to order infrastructure and have that brought into the data centers. The other side is, think of the platform as a service. Why even worry about the monitoring and the management of that infrastructure if we don't have to? In many ways, I look at that as like pizza delivery. It gets you what you want so that you can get down to enjoying what you need. And then when those options work, look at the software as a service play. Because if they can take care of everything, so you just need to worry about the data and your users and their access to that data, that allows us to focus on meaningful pursuits in our business and help grow it instead of worrying about the infrastructure stuff that we don't need to worry about if we can help to delegate some of that, not abdicate, but delegate some of that stuff to the cloud vendor like Microsoft. Anyways, I hope that's helpful. I really need to get into this pizza. I'll talk to you on the next show. Hope you'll subscribe, hope you'll hit like. Let us know what you think in the comments. Hey, let me know what's your favorite pizza. Put that in the comments. That's probably more interesting anyways. Till next time, we'll talk to you in the next video. Can't a guy have a piece of pizza in peace? Go, just go.